Welcome to the great Exodus years, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael, I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is, my temple is holy. What is the temple of the Lord? The temple of the Lord is our body. Our complete body is the temple of the Lord. And now you decide what you place in this temple. You decide what you are looking for and what you are placing in. Do not do it as the money changers and the business people that were at Jesus' time in the temple, and Jesus came and threw them all out by force. Because he said, my temple is a temple of prayer and worship and not of business or worldly desires. But many people nowadays are filling their temple with temptations of the world, with Xbox video games, with movies from Hollywood, with business desires, with riches and money, with their careers and their elevation over their neighbors. But these are not the things that are holy. On the contrary, these are all sins. So why are you filling your temple with these bad things? Has Jesus not shown you that you should clean your temple and take out everything from the world? So why are you filling it with worldly things? You have to understand that Jesus is not from this world. And you also have to understand that the narrow path is a heavenly path and not a worldly path. So if you still stay in the world, you are not walking that narrow and righteous path. You have to focus 100% on the heavenly kingdom and not on the world, not on your careers, not on your money, not on your business. Do not believe anybody who tells you God is blessing your business. What has the Lord to do with your worldly desires? Nothing. He is promoting the heavenly paradise. He is promoting the heavenly things. And many times Jesus has said, take your cross, give everything from the world away, and follow me. You follow him to where? Where are you going with Jesus? To heaven. You are going with him to the holy mountain, to Mount Zion. But you can only travel there and be found worthy to escape all these things if you separate yourself from the world. Very soon this world will be given over to a new Pharaoh, the Antichrist, and his helper, the false prophet. And when that will happen, you will have no chance to escape him anymore, because you are stuck in your careers and in your business. And whatever you do, he will tell you, take the mark of the beast to make business, take the mark of the beast to stay in your careers. Take the mark of the beast if you want to watch this movie or that movie. You will have to take that mark of the beast. And if not, and you refuse, and you are in the world, you will die as a murderer. That's the reason why the Lord says, now it's a time to come out. Come out of the world and out of Babylon, the false churches that are promoting business, that are promoting worldly things, that are tolerant to everything, no matter if it's gay or not gay or whatever they do, they tolerate just everything because they want the people, and with the people the money comes. All these are worldly churches. All these are worldly prophets. And how can a worldly prophet teach you about the heavenly things? He cannot, because he is a false prophet. He is talking about his master, and his master is Satan, because Satan is the ruler of this world. But Jesus and the Father, they rule heaven and the universe. They rule the place where we want to go, where we want to go to. We want to go to paradise. We want to go to the third heaven. We want to escape all the things in this world. We have to separate ourselves and clean our garments in the blood of the Lamb. through the righteous deeds of the saints. Because it's clearly written, the multitude that is standing at the base of Mount Zion, at the sixth seal, and who will go to heaven? What do they have on? White, fine linen. And it's also clarified what represents this white, fine linen, the righteous deeds of the saints. And that is active work. Good works after you are saved, good works. John the Baptist, with the spirit of Elijah, has told you, people, he has told you in Luke 3 that the axe will come to every tree that will not bear good fruits. And I'm sorry, these people who believe they are saved and they don't have anything to do, they are not bearing any fruit. Without bearing fruits, the axe will come, your tree will be chopped off and will be burned in the fire. Read Luke 3, what John the Baptist has said. And John the Baptist was a forerunner of Jesus Christ and in the spirit of Elijah. And is it not said in Malachi 4 that before Jesus comes and feet down on the Mount of Olives, before he comes, Elijah will appear? This is the time now. Elijah is here and Elijah will call you to repent your sins and to walk in obedience to the Lord and to bring forth much fruit. So do not pollute your temple. Do not fill it with worldly things. And do not listen to false prophets who say, oh, God has told me this month he will bless your business. What has the Lord to do with your business? This is a worldly issue. Remember that the temple is a holy place, as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is holy and his Father is holy. So you should also be holy. But you cannot be holy if you are standing in the world that belongs to Satan. One leg in the world, one leg in heaven. That makes you lukewarm. And Jesus has said in Revelation that if you remain lukewarm, he will spit you out of his mouth. And lukewarm were churches, lukewarm were believers, because they never brought forth any fruits. They believed in something false, and then they were sitting down and waiting for Jesus to come. But when Jesus came, he told them, you, I do not know you. You have not brought forth anything. You have not brought in the harvest, and you have done nothing for my heavenly kingdom. All what you did was you enjoyed your worldly affairs. So you will not come with me into paradise. Do not be like that. Come out of the world. If you do not know how to come out of the world, send me an email at triplegrace55@gmail.com and I will help you. If you want to know how to establish a dwelling place of Zion, the lights that are the Lord is lit, burning right now in all the nations, he will establish the lights everywhere. And you can also establish one light in your home and in your neighborhood. If you do not know how to do that, how to establish a dwelling place of Zion, then follow the link in the first pinned comment. We have a training academy. In this training academy, we tell you how to become an elder, establish a dwelling place of Zion. Or in the other training, we tell you how to separate yourself from the world so that you can be found counted worthy to escape all these things. And this is a bride who will escape. A part of this bride will escape to the third heaven. A part of the bride will agree to remain, to bring in the harvest of the ages. And from this part that will remain, even a smaller part, will then be part of the 144,000 who will stay during the trumpet periods. These people are not anymore called servant of the Lord. They are then called a bondservant. What is the difference between a servant and a bondservant? The bondservant is already set free from the master. But because he loves the master so much, he decides to stay and continue with the master. and dedicate himself to the master and do the work that the master will command him. That is a bondservant. All of you that establish dwelling places of Zion will be bondservants of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So become one. Follow the links in the first pinned comment. And if you're guided to sow into the ministry and help us to spread the messages, please, the links for PayPal and the description box and also in the pinned comments. Help us to spread the message and to bring the people out of the world, onto the righteous and narrow path, to the holy mountain, to Mount Zion, so that they can be raptured at the sixth seal into paradise. Thank you that you have listened to this topic, and I hope I will see you again tomorrow. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.